Hello friends,
today we'll be discussing about scalar and vector quantities. Scalar quantities are those which have got a magnitude but no direction. For example, the mass, length, volume, resistance. For all these cases, we only need to talk about the magnitudes, and in no way direction is associated with these quantities. For vector quantities, on the other hand, we have to talk about magnitude as well as a specified direction. For example, force, velocity, moment, and pressure. For all these cases, we have to talk about the magnitude of these vectors as well as the direction in which they are acting. Now let's take a vector f, another one is g. So these two vectors here are coplanar and they're also collinear, that is, they're acting on the same plane, and also they're parallel to each other, acting on the same line. So in this case, if we want to find the resultant r of the addition of f and g, we have to go for simply adding the magnitudes. That is, the resultant magnitude will be the addition of the magnitudes of f and g, and the resultant will also be acting in the same direction as f and g. Now if we have to subtract g from f, we simply reverse the vector g. So here the direction of the g vector is reversed, but the magnitude remains the same. This is how we calculate the difference of the two vectors f and g. The resultant will be the magnitudes of f and g subtracted from each other, and the resultant will act in the direction of the vector with a greater magnitude. Now f and g here are acting in opposite directions. The same can be represented by this diagram, where they again act in opposite directions. Both of them give the same result. Now if we take two vectors f and g, but in this case f and g are coplanar but they are not collinear. So let like this. So here what happens, they are coplanar but they are not collinear, and g acts at an angle theta, for example, to the direction of f. So in that case, the resultant r will be found by joining the open-ended tips of f and g to complete a triangle, and this is called triangle law of addition of vectors. So this is where there is a difference between scalar addition and vector addition. So for in these kinds of situations, we also need to find the direction of r. So that is, for example, here we take phi, which is for example, r acts at an angle phi to the vector f. So here also we will denote r as the addition of f and g, but this is not a simple scalar addition of magnitudes of f and g, but a vector addition where we also take into consideration the direction of the individual vectors. So let's start with the vector g, which is at an angle theta to the direction of f. So we draw perpendicular to the direction of f, and now we find the horizontal component of g, which is along f, that is g cos theta, and the vertical component of f, which is perpendicular to the direction of f. Sorry, the vertical component of g here. So g cos theta and g sin theta are the horizontal and vertical components of g, and g cos theta is along the direction of f, and g sin theta is perpendicular to the direction of f. So now we can simplify this by drawing a right angle triangle, where the f plus g cos theta is the base, g sin theta is the height, and r is the hypotenuse. So by Pythagorean theorem, we can say that r square will be equals to f plus g cos theta whole square plus g sin theta whole square. So simplifying that, we'll get r square will be equals to f square plus g square plus 2fg cos theta, and the direction of r will be given by phi, where tan phi will be equal to g sin theta divided by f plus g cos theta. So this is how we represent the addition of vectors when they're non-collinear. Now, if we have to go for a subtraction of one vector from the other, so here we see, if you have to find f minus g, we simply take the magnitude of g and reverse the direction. So that becomes minus g. In other words, we can also represent x to be equal to minus g, where magnitude of x and g will be the same and only the direction will change. So the resultant will be equals to f minus g or equals to f plus x. In other words, we can show that subtraction of vectors is nothing but the addition of vectors with the direction reversed. So here we'll use the same formula for the addition of vectors in case we're subtracting, only substituting the magnitude of x instead of magnitude of g, and instead of the angle theta, we are substituting it with 180 minus theta. So the formula remains the same, but there will be two changes, where r square will be equals to f square plus g square minus 2fg cos theta, and tan phi will be equals to g sin theta divided by f minus g cos theta. That's how we subtract vectors. That's all, guys. Thank you.